Many projects choose not to build their own networks, but run on an established one instead. In case you are planning to do the same and run your project as a token, NFT, or a dApp on a network, this video will help you pick the right one for you. In today's episode, we will have a detailed analysis of some of the major blockchain networks to help you decide which one is better for you at this time. Hi, I'm Vlad. Here is your Bunny Money channel with the weekly dose of finance and blockchain news and tutorials. If you would like to obtain knowledge, you came to the right place. The entire blockchain industry is constantly changing. You see projects come up and go. We see hype around certain things like NFTs, DeFi 2.0, Metaverse, etc. Whatever the project, it's usually based on a specific network, an industrial chain. These networks constantly compete with each other in order to grow, become more efficient, and have a bigger market capitalization. The bigger the volume, the stronger their voice, and the more opportunities they have. For someone who plans to launch a project, however, the ever-growing choice of networks might seem daunting. But we have a simple answer for you. The best network for your project is Ethereum! And that's it for our video. Just kidding. Before we dive in, I will tell you that first of all, you need a clear understanding of what your project would be. Does it revolve around a token, an NFT, or a dApp? What does it do exactly, and what is the utility? Each of these factors would ultimately decide the best pick of the network, since each of them has its own unique advantages and disadvantages. Some were built for transactions, and others have a better support for smart contracts, meaning that you would be able to run your token or an NFT on them. And of course, you must consider which network is more popular. You should look at the rankings. You can see top 100 networks sorted by volume and market capitalization. We won't cover all of them, but focus only on the big ones. The bigger the network, the more users it has. If your project runs on such a network, it means better accessibility and a smaller threshold for your users to find your project. Just to give you an example, everyone knows about Ethereum, even those who are completely new to the entire idea of blockchain. Those who are just joining to the cryptosphere would most likely begin their research by studying Bitcoin and Ethereum. Or take Polygon, a terrific layer 2 solution. You most likely won't hear about it without learning about Ethereum first. You won't understand its importance before realizing Ethereum's scalability problems and sky-high gas fees. But in today's analysis, we will compare 5 main networks. Ethereum, BSC, Polygon, Avalanche, and Solana. The first thing you need to know about your project is what it is exactly. Whether it is an NFT collection, a token, or a decentralized game that requires high speed and high transaction frequency, all these factors will influence your choice. We have 9 different aspects of comparison. These are network speed, transaction frequency, network security, rate of projects succeeded on the blockchain, network ecosystem, language and EVM compatibility, network gas fees, network size or its popularity, and price evaluation. Transaction speed is one of the main factors when it comes to choosing the network. If it is a cryptocurrency or a dApp, the transaction speed must be efficient. The higher the speed, the better the data transfer and transaction confirmation. Transaction speed depends on many factors such as block size, transaction fees, block time, network usage, etc. Transaction frequency is another important aspect when it comes to choosing the network. In case your project is a simple token which represents value and you do not expect it to be traded frequently, the low throughput of the network and transaction time will be okay. But if you run a token around a decentralized game or NFTs, which are going to frequently interact with the network, you would need to think of other faster networks. Let me give you some examples. A crypto NFT collection such as CryptoPunks or Apes were created as collectibles without actual utility, which means people are not going to trade it often and a constant interaction with the smart contract isn't required. You bought it, you hold it, and sell it. No other stuff. However, if your project runs as a decentralized application such as crypto game, it would not be a good option to choose a slow network. High-frequency projects would require a quicker blockchain which can handle more transactions per second with lesser fees. Games based on blockchain usually require a high quantity of transactions. Security of the blockchain is another important aspect. The longer a blockchain exists, the bigger it gets, the safer it becomes. Not long ago, Ronin blockchain, which Axie Infinity was using, was hacked. Ronin Network is a game-focused network initially created for Axie Infinity. Another case, in August 2021, a hacker successfully made more than $600 million on Poly Network, though the vast majority of funds was returned by him later. So if the network on which your project runs is getting exploited by hackers, it would lead to problems for you. Big networks don't usually have security issues, unless you interact with third-party malicious contracts, which may lead to security breaches. So before choosing the network, please make sure it is big and does not have a history of security problems. Rate of success is the actual probability of becoming successful as a blockchain project. If we open the operator, we can filter all the projects on each network and see the exact balance and volume of each. So as we can see, games on Ethereum do not accumulate a lot of users, around 30 to 50 daily users, because of high gas fees. Compare the number to Polygon, where there are projects with tens of thousands of daily unique users. So as you can see, there is a correlation between industries and networks. Environment, or as I call it, ecosystem, is another important aspect. For example, we can see that the environment of Binance Smart Chain is very strong. They have a lot of different products built around it, and they have a major exchange. However, if we talk about NFTs, we will always think first about OpenSea, which is the first on the list. Unfortunately, OpenSea does not support NFTs run on Binance Smart Chain. And if your project is about an NFT collection and it's run on Binance Smart Chain, you won't have access to OpenSea audience. Language and compatibility is another issue which you will encounter when choosing the network. The most common networks are EVM compatible, meaning that you will be able to use Solidity language to write a contract, and it would be much easier for you to learn it or find someone who is an expert at it. Some other networks use other languages, and if your team is not familiar with those languages, it would be really hard to create something new on it. Price evaluation is the amount of money people usually tend to spend when they are interacting with a project. As we know, most users tend to spend more on Ethereum because they know it is a more expensive network, so they are prepared to pay more. However, when they use Polygon, they expect cheaper prices and are not ready to pay more than what they consider is an acceptable price for Polygon. An example would be an NFT collection on Ethereum and Polygon. As you know, most people assume that Polygon is a cheaper alternative to Ethereum, which means that if they are on Polygon, they will most likely assume that your NFTs should be cheap, and they are not going to pay the same amount of money for your NFT as they would on Ethereum. Gas fees are the primary concern of users when it comes to choosing whether to interact with your product or not. High gas fees will probably create some distance between customers and your project. And popularity of the network can't be ignored. The more popular the network, the more users it will have. More users means higher adoption levels. Higher adoption levels means more users will be aware of and possibly use your project. Okay, let's get to the exact comparison. Ethereum is my most favorite, and it's same for many others. It has the most users, it is the most popular network, the earliest one, and most creative one. There were many networks and ideas trying to copy Ethereum, but even with all its good, it still has some disadvantages. They are gas fees and speed. If you run a DApp project like a game where you need high-frequency contract interaction, it would not be a good option to run your project on Ethereum network for now. As you know, Ethereum is planning to move from proof-of-work to proof-of-stake model. Ethereum high gas fees and its scalability problem forced it to begin its move to POS consensus mechanism, which intends to reduce gas fees long term. The transition to POS will consist of two steps, one called merge and another sharding. It will increase the number of transactions Ethereum can handle. Assuming that the demand for Ethereum will not change, this will decrease network's gas fees. But I personally believe the demand for Ethereum will only rise over time. So how much gas fees will decrease still remains a big question. Everyone has been waiting for a long time for Ethereum 2.0 update, and many believe that sharding will happen in the middle of 2023. The current Ethereum network has 25 transactions per second and around 6 minutes of real transaction time. And after the Ethereum 2.0 update, we would probably see really good improvements with the speed and gas fees. Binance Smart Chain boasts smart contract functionality and compatibility with the EVM, which means you can run your Ethereum smart contract on BSC network. The gas fees are slightly cheaper, around 4 cents if you send money to another wallet, and around 40 cents if you use PancakeSwap. It has a huge following and a bigger user base. Many people have BNB in their wallets and the network is quick. For the token and medium frequency smart contract interaction, it would be a great choice. Talking about cons, we need to mention NFTs. You can say that for now, if you don't have an ability to code and your project has NFTs, BSC would not be the best option. As for now, there are not as many solid projects that represent NFT industry better than OpenSea. And as you know, OpenSea currently only supports Ethereum, Polygon, Solana, and Clayton. BSC has been trying really hard to establish their industry and products around NFTs. We have Binance NFTs. So maybe in the nearest future, we would see more popular ideas and platforms which run around NFTs on Binance Smart Chain. A layer 2 scalable solution for Ethereum Polygon found its footing due to its speed and cost effectiveness. It has a throughput of 65,000 transactions per second. The speed is high, the environment is not too great, however, Polygon is great for NFTs. The Polygon blockchain supports NFT platforms such as OpenSea, which means that if your project is about an NFT collection, it would be a great option to choose. OpenSea has been positioning themselves as an NFT marketplace and become the biggest one. Another advantage of Polygon is that it has very low gas fees. Compared to other networks, transactions on Polygon cost a fraction of a cent. For example, if you send your Matic to another wallet, it would cost a fraction of a cent. Even if you increase your gas fees for better speed or even interact with other smart contracts such as QuickSwap, you can still conduct many transactions and it will still cost you a fraction of a cent. Okay, let's talk about cons when it comes to Polygon. The first one would be risks associated with Ethereum 2.0. Because Polygon was created as Ethereum's layer 2 solution to reduce gas fees and increase transaction speed, once Ethereum changes, there might not be a need for Polygon. Short term, it will not have an impact to Polygon, but long term, it will have a big impact, unless Polygon team finds other ways and utility, which is what Polygon team is trying to do. They have a very good technological base and they have a lot of possible variations of how it can work out for them. The main thing with Polygon brand is that usually you will never hear this name all on its own, especially if you are a new to blockchain. After you start to dive in, you will find out about Ethereum's gas fees and scalability problems, and only after that you will start learning about Polygon. Avalanche's tests show that blockchain can handle around 4,500 transactions per second, while the full production-ready version of Avalanche is able to achieve 20,000 transactions per second, with a transaction time of 1 to 2 seconds. It's quick and the gas fees are slightly lower. Unfortunately, the environment is not bigger than on other networks, but it is EVM compatible, which means you would be able to run your Ethereum smart contract code on Avalanche. For token projects and NFT collections, it would be a good choice. Solana is another interesting blockchain network. Solana network processes around 3,000 transactions per second. Solana claims a theoretical maximum of 50,000 transactions per second. The Solana blockchain is the second fastest blockchain with a huge transaction speed. The transaction time is 3 to 10 seconds. Gas fees are low, around $0.0002. It utilizes proof of history and proof of stake consensus mechanism. In case your project is about gaming and high frequency smart contract interactions, it would be a great choice. Unfortunately, it is not EVM compatible. These are the networks which are on our list, but just to give you an idea of other projects that might be a good option in the future, let's talk about Cardano and others. Cardano network has been reported to be capable of processing a maximum of 250 TPS. Cardano is an open source public blockchain network which runs on the proof of stake. It was founded by a co-founder of Ethereum, with a transaction time of 1 to 10 minutes. Cardano is a blockchain platform that focuses on community participation and security. While it doesn't have the fastest transaction speeds on this list, it does offer a high degree of security. Their transaction fee is currently in the range of 31 cents. EOS is a blockchain-based decentralized platform which was created for mainly dApps. It can process around 4,000 transactions per second. It is one of my least favorite networks, however. Fantom, AVAX, and Terra are all networks which you can also consider and research more. A couple of important suggestions before you make a decision. When you create a project, don't try to make it multi-chain or cross-chain, as it is really hard and it takes a lot of money and effort to create a secure cross-chain product. If you think your NFTs would be on Polygon and your token would be on Solana, this also wouldn't work for you and your users. You should reduce the complexity when letting users interact with your product. Which is why stick with one network if you can. No matter how many features your project has, it should be based on one blockchain network. However, in the future, in case your project grows, you can think about how to create a bridge, which will enable users to use your product on other chains as well. My second suggestion would be if you think about network migration, understand the complexity of this task. Moving a project to another chain is a big deal and a lot of work. As we said before, the bigger the network, the better chance that your project will succeed. But this is a double-edged sword. When you become big, there is only so much time and effort that you spend on supporting all projects on your network, so the competition is high. However, if you are lucky enough and run a project on a smaller network, this network might have more resources to support your project. We have seen examples of it on the AVAX chain. On the other hand, do not count on the network ecosystem so much and don't see it as the main force behind your project. Instead, focus on the project itself and which network will work better with it. This is your main key to success. And view the network as a project too. Networks constantly compete with each other, and some that might look best today might not be so appealing tomorrow. For me personally, my favorite network is Ethereum, but currently I'm working on a project that requires frequent transactions and cheaper gas fees, which is why I chose another network. And keep in mind that none of the information provided is financial advice and is given to you for educational purposes only. Always do your own research. This was our episode. Hope it was useful for you. Here is your Bunny Money channel. I'm Vlad. Please don't forget to leave comments, hit the like button and subscribe. See you in the next episode.